Hey guys, a very warm welcome to all of you to Unacademy, which is India's largest online learning portal. And today we are going to do this chapter, which is called An Indian American Woman in Space, Kalpana Chawla. And this is chapter number 4 from your book, Honeysuckle. And as you guys already know, you can ace your exams with Unacademy's Plus subscription, which is now coming to you at a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. Also, welcome to my class, dear learners. My name is Sweksha and I am your English educator. It is my passion to learn and teach English, and which is why I am here teaching you this chapter in English today. Alright, so let's begin with this chapter, which is An Indian American Woman in Space, Kalpana Chawla. But before we do that, let's look at what the chapter has to ask us before we start reading. Okay, so we need to use a dictionary and find the meaning of all the words which are mentioned here. So I have done that for you. So the first word is naturalized US citizen. Naturalized means nothing but to accept the citizenship of any other country apart from your own. Okay. Space in this context means the space which is outside of Earth. Okay. Anything which is outside Earth is space. Frontiers means borders. Okay. And abroad means in any other country apart from your own. Now, how is liftoff different from takeoff? Well, during a takeoff, the flight is not exactly completely vertical, but a liftoff happens mostly with a spacecraft which goes vertically into space. It is completely vertical, and that is how it is different from a takeoff. So Kalpana Chawla said that she never dreamt as a child in Karnal that she would cross the frontiers of space. It was enough that her parents allowed her to attend engineering college after she graduated from Tagore School. We can make a note of the school where she graduated from. It's called Tagore School. After a Bachelor of Science degree in aeronautical engineering, against great opposition from her father, she went for her master's degree to United States of America. She later earned her PhD in aerospace engineering. So Kalpana Chawla had done aeronautical engineering, okay, and that was even after her father opposed her. After that, she went to United States of America to have a master's degree in aeronautical engineering, and after that she got her PhD in aerospace engineering. So Kalpana Chawla was the first Indian American woman astronaut to blast off from the launch pad at Cape Canaveral, Florida, and participate in a successful mission in space. Her family from India cheered along with staff at the Kennedy Space Center as they watched Columbia lift off. So Columbia was the name of her spacecraft. Kalpana was born in Karnal in Haryana, but was naturalized US citizen. So we read just now what is naturalized. Naturalized means to take any other country's citizenship. And she was married to flight instructor Jean-Pierre Harrison. Okay. Besides being an astronaut, she was licensed to fly single and multi-engine land airplanes, single engine seaplanes and gliders. So she was very qualified as a pilot. She could fly gliders and seaplanes. She was also a certified flight instructor. After qualifying as a pilot, Kalpana began to consider another challenge, applying to NASA's space shuttle program. She was first hired as a research scientist at NASA in 1994. She was selected by NASA for training as an astronaut. So in 1994, she applied and she was selected by NASA to train as an astronaut. When asked about what it was like being a woman in her field, she replied, "I really never ever thought while pursuing my studies or doing anything else that I was a woman or a person from a small city or a different country. I pretty much followed them, and people who were around me. Fortunately, always encouraged me and said, "It's if that's what you want to do, carry on." So she was always encouraged, and she never thought that she was a woman or she was from a small town. She always knew her powers and she followed her dreams. Kalpana's first space mission in Space Shuttle Columbia was 15 days, 16 hours and 34 minutes long. During this time, she went around the Earth 252 times, okay? So she circled around Earth 252 times, traveling 10.45 million kilometers. The crew included a Japanese and a Ukrainian astronaut. So there were two other people, a Japanese and a Ukrainian astronaut. The crew performed experiments such as pollinating plants to observe food growth in space and tests for making stronger metals and faster computer chips, all for a price tag of about $56 million. So the Columbia space shuttle in space costed us $56 million. On Saturday night, when the news about Columbia disaster broke, there was a shock and disbelief. The town of Karnal spent a sleepless night as thousands of households stayed glued to the television, which means they could not stop looking for the news about Kalpana Chawla. Says, in the hope that Kalpana and crew had somehow survived. A journalist wrote, "She was a heroine. It takes enormous ability to become an astronaut. You need to know astrophysics to aeronautical engineering. In this age of super specialization, you must have an encyclopedic knowledge to be an astronaut." Her achievements were awe-inspiring. So she needs you need a lot of things to be able to qualify as a astronaut. For millions of young Indians, the story of Kalpana Chawla, a girl from a small town who touched the skies, had become an inspiration. In a message that she sent from abroad the space shuttle, from aboard the space shuttle Columbia to students of her college in Chandigarh, Kalpana said, "The path from dreams to success does exist. May you have the vision to find it, the courage to get into it, get onto it. Wishing you a great journey. There will surely be many who start off on this journey to fulfill their dreams." And let me just check if it was aboard or abroad we were looking for. Okay, aboard means to be on board of a flight or a ship, and abroad means to be outside your country. So where was Kalpana Chawla born? Why is she called an Indian American? As we see from this chapter, that Kalpana Chawla was born in the city of Karnal in Haryana, but she had gone abroad to study aeronautical engineering, and after her studies she took up the US citizenship. When and why did she go to the US, and who did she marry? So we will see that in lines 2 and 3, in paragraph 2 and 3. So after her bachelor in science, bachelor of science degree in aeronautical engineering, against great opposition, she went for a master's degree to the United States. So she had gone for the master's degree in aeronautical engineering to the United States of America, and she also earned her PhD in aerospace engineering. Okay, and she married Jean-Pierre Harrison, who was a flight instructor, right? How did she become an astronaut? What gave her the idea that she could be an astronaut? So she was a trained pilot, right? We see that she was a trained pilot and she could fly gliders and seaplanes and all of that. So she decided to take up a course with NASA, and NASA admitted her into a course to be an astronaut. What abilities must an astronaut have according to the journalist? So let's look at that page. It said that you need to know a lot about everything from biology to astrophysics to aeronautical engineering. So you need to know biology, astrophysics, and aeronautical engineering to be an astronaut. Describe Kalpana Chawla's first mission in the space. So Kalpana Chawla's first mission in the space went on for 15 days. I think that's what is mentioned in the book. It went for 15 days, 16 hours and 34 minutes long. And she went 252 times around the Earth. And she traveled 10.45 million kilometers, right? So that was her first space journey. What does Kalpana Chawla say about pursuing your dream? Do you agree with that success is possible? So she says that you must follow your dreams, right? You must have a vision and the courage to go after that vision. And I think we must all agree with what she has to say because she did it for real. And that was your chapter about Kalpana Chawla, who was the first Indian American woman in space. And let's discuss now about the Unacademy's Plus subscription features. You can learn live from the comfort of your home. There's unlimited access to all the courses. Top educators of India on one platform are available and they will teach you in live classes. Regular doubt clearing and answer writing sessions are also available. Exhaustive coverage of syllabus, mentorship and guidance. There is study material that you can get in PDF format. Practice test, live test series and batch courses. The pricing for the Unacademy's Plus subscription is available on the screen right now and you can use my code SWS10 to get a flat 10% discount. Unacademy's iconic subscription features are personal mentorship, live doubt solving, weekly report, parent connect, study planner and all the benefits of the Unacademy's Plus subscription. The pricing is on the screen right now and as usual you can get a flat 10% off if you use my code SWS10. So with that we come to the end of this chapter, but I will be back soon with chapter number 5. Until then, please like, share and subscribe to this video and our channel. Also do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you never ever miss any class from us. Thanks a lot for watching and I will see you soon. Bye bye.